Amen. You raise me up, Lord. You raise me up.
Oh, Father God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for waking us up today, giving us the breath of life and everything else. We thank you for all the blessings that you've put into our lives, oh, Father God. And may you please keep on blessing us every single day. and help us as well to be a blessing to everyone that we see and everyone that we meet, oh Father God. We thank you for the preacher of the day. May you please bless her and shine your light on her, oh Father God. And may you please bless the words that come out of her mouth today. May it bless us, and may we leave with something that we have learned and taken from it. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen.
Amen, amen. Thank you, Vanya, for that prayer. With that prayer and all the music we have enjoyed so far, I welcome you, my beloved friends. I welcome you in the name of Jesus. This is our third day, the last, but not least. You know that some people like to keep the best for the last. So watch out what's coming this day. I promised you yesterday, if you thought you had seen it all, more is coming and more is better than less. Amen. And so the servant of the Most High, the woman of God, is packed up by the power of the Holy Spirit to continue to care for our souls, to feed us and to give us a new direction as she revives us with the powerful word of God. I welcome you, friends, on the YouTube, on the Facebook Live, all of you that I am enjoying your beautiful faces on Zoom, and those that I only get to enjoy the beautiful names and the beautiful phone numbers that I see on the screen. Hallelujah. It is all good whenever we meet together. When the people of faith gather in the name of Jesus, there is a promise from the Lord. The Lord himself has promised us that whenever and wherever we gather in the name of Jesus, God himself makes self present amongst us. And so tonight we are not alone. We are with God, the God we worship, the God we praise, and the God we testify about is right here with us as we call upon God's name. And so tonight we are going to be reminded of the scriptures that are guiding us in this three-day revival that is ending tonight. The scriptures are taken from the book of Acts, chapter 3, verses 6 through 8. Very short, but tremendously powerful. And so Sister Sierra Smith Vasquez, one of our youth members at St. Mark's United Methodist Church, she's going to bless our hearts as she reads the word of God with power.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
The scripture reading is taken from Acts chapter 3, verse 6 through verse 8. Peter said, "I have no silver or gold, but what I have I give you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Stand up and walk." And he took him by the right hand and raised him up, and immediately his feet and ankles were made strong. Jumping up, he stood and began to walk, and he entered the temple with them, walking and leaping and praising God. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Praise be to God. Thank you so very much for that beautiful reading of the word of God. And so now we are going to enjoy one more song. My hope is built in nothing less. My hope. And so as we prepare to share this song, we are going to as well prepare our hearts and our minds to receive the word of God and to hear after this song from none other but the Reverend Wendy Paul. And you know, something is coming, that much you can count on. Amen, somebody.
Thank you.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Thanks be to God. I'm so grateful to be here once again on the third night of this beautiful revival. I'm so grateful, just grateful that I was invited. I'm grateful to be a part of this great connection of churches. And I'm just grateful that you all have come out once again to revive and worship together once again. Let us pray. Dear God of all creation, you are the God of compassion. You are the God who separates us from the chaos, who allows us to walk in your order, in your perfect will. You're the one who gave us our fingerprint and designed us. You are the one who set the oceans in place, separating the land from the waters. God, we are grateful. We are grateful that we can know that we are redeemed by you. And as long as we are in you and we dwell in you, you dwell in us, and we bear much fruit. Lord, we want to be a getting up church, and we want to be a praising church. And God, we want to be a church where you dwell in us as your temples. Lord God, you would cross the oceans to come and find us. You would get up from your holy mountain to come and find us. Allow for us to be the love of Christ in a way that others who have not yet seen your light, who have not yet experienced your love, who have not yet experienced your grace, that we would be doors to individuals who are down. Allow for us to be strengthened and to take our authority in you. Let the words of our mouths and the meditation of our hearts, oh God, be acceptable and pleasing in your sight. Let everything that we do and say come through the frame of love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. So this week we've been talking, and the revival's scripture was very short and it was sweet. It wasn't just short, it was sweet. It told us something very, very important. It gave us some insight about who we are and where our authority is and what we can do with it. It told us that Peter and John had the authority to say to the man, in the name of Jesus Christ, that was the authority, get up. And I challenged you on Wednesday to speak to your circumstances and to see your circumstances from an upright position, even if it's not so yet. And then yesterday, we talked about the man who was lame, and he got up. And the next thing he did was he went and praised. And yesterday I told you about the different forms of praise, but I didn't get to tell you some of the things. I think I was moving a little too fast. But the praise that he was exercising, there's various different types of praise, right? And one praise is one hand, which is the right hand. The one hand is the right hand where we are saying, thank you, God. Thank you, Lord, with our right hand. And then there's another praise where we're saying, Daddy, as if we're almost like, Abba, pick me up. And that's when we lift up both of our hands and we praise God. And we know that this man got up. We know that he praised God. And the next thing he did was he went to the temple with Peter and John. And some of us have been in our homes and we've been saying, I don't know. I don't know how I feel about getting back out into the community. I don't know how I feel about going back into the streets. And what I'm here to remind us today is that the scriptures tell us, do not neglect the fellowship of the saints. Do not neglect going to the temple. He ran to the temple dancing and jumping. And some of us might say, well, does that mean I just got to go to church? Well, I'm inviting you to come back to church. We're inviting you to come back to believe and know that God has your back and that you can come back and you can be amongst the saints, because iron sharpens iron. We strengthen each other when we come together. So Peter and John had a compassion and empathy. And this word compassion is very important. It's important because this is the description of our God. This is the description of the God that we serve. The people in the ancient times had all sorts of mythologies and all sorts of various different gods that they worshiped. And one of the very distinct things about our God, Yahweh God, is that our Yahweh God is compassionate. You might say, well, Pastor Wendy, what are you talking about with this compassionate? What are you saying? Why are you telling us about this compassionate? Well, I loved it in school at Drew when I took Hebrew. And at first, I was really afraid of Hebrew. I was very, very afraid because I felt like I can't learn a whole nother language. And after a while, I got myself in there because I had to. It was a required class. And when I was in school, I learned the Hebrew alphabet. And to this day, I still remember most of it. And it goes, Chalif Bet Gimel Dalif Ha Mount Zion Hetek Yaakov Lamed. That's where I mess up at, the last ones. But I want to give you what the word compassion means. The word compassion in the most ancient understanding, in the most clearness, is Rosh, which is one of the alphabet. And the next one, and Rosh means the prince of power. And after Rosh, oh no, hold on. Oof. Guys, can you see me? You got me, right? You said you guys can still see me, right?
Yes, we see you.
Perfect. All right, I'm so sorry about this. I gotta pull it up on my phone. So there's Rosh and there's Chat and there's Men. And if you look at these alphabets and what they mean, Rosh means the prince of power, which is the enemy. And then Chet means a separation. It's a separation. It's a chism. It's a fenced around. And Men, let me make sure I got this right. Mem, this means God's compassion is about eternal life. But let me make sure I got this right, guys. Mem is the word, it's chaos and water. And the word compassion comes to, and you say, well, how does that come to the definition of compassion? How is this the devourer and the prince of the air and then a fenced in and then chaos? And what this means is what it actually interprets is that the scripture, this actual word, compassion, is saying that God separates us from what was destined to happen to us. We were destined for destruction because we're in a place under the prince of the air, who is wickedness. And we also are in a place where it was chaotic and this chaos. And if you know anything about the ancient beliefs, there were many beliefs and there were many, many types of gods that they believed in. And morals wasn't really a thing. So then here's this monotheistic God who comes and he literally, or she, let's get it right. He, she, right? She, he, because God is God, right? God is not male or female, though we understand all the different attributes of God. So God is now showing us that God separated us out that we would not enter into our inevitable fate. And when we see this guy on the ground, it looks like it's inevitable that he's just gonna die there. It looks like he's not gonna ever be able to get up. But these two disciples of Jesus Christ, they come to him and they say, in the name of Jesus Christ, get up. And he gets up and he starts to praise and he runs to the temple. He goes dancing and celebrating. And this temple that we all know, when we know our Hebrew Bible, we understand that the temple is a very important place, that God ordered everything that was done to build the temple. We understand that the temple is a place where God dwells, but we also know that there are visions of God, God's self, getting up and following God's people wherever they were into exile. So we have a God that's compassionate enough to get up and come and find us. We have a God that's compassionate enough to come and separate us from the chaos. Now we are called to be as Christ Jesus, because Jesus says, come to me, all you who are weary. Come to me, all you who are heavy laden. I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. So then you might ask, well, Pastor, how do I get up and praise, and how do I get to the temple? First, I want you to recognize that the temple is you. You are the temple. And this is why it's meant for us as the temple of God, to be the temple of God, to praise God and to acknowledge God's goodness and to glorify God and worship God. We're not only just to acknowledge that we are the temple, but we are meant to meet and gather amongst each other and be with each other in communion with one another. And this is the way of God. This is the way of the God that we serve, that is the God of all the universe. So we might ask, well, how can I be the temple of God? You can be the temple of God by being one who puts away all of the things that hold you down. When you feel them inside of you, when you get around people who speak negative, when you get that phone call from Sister So-and-so who always got something negative to say, you can say, this is not on the side of relief. This is not on the side of peace. This is not on the side of joy. I must let this go. When this man got up and went to the temple, he went with the people who showed him how to get free. He went with the people who showed him how to find his source. And as he went, he ran right into the church. So we've preached, get up, we've spoken, praise God, and now go to church. Go to church and be the church. Don't just sit at home on your Zoom and say, I'm all right, because there's something that's not happening when you're not gathering with the saints. The Bible tells us that iron does sharpen iron. That means that you got to be in the vicinity to actually experience this sharpening. So I'm challenging you to get to church and to invite others to church, to invite your friends to church. Pastor Quissico and I, we will partner forever. Want to know why? Because we're not in competition with each other. We are people who want to spread the love of God and get people up off the ground. The Good Samaritan got the guy off the ground. Our faith is about getting up off the ground. This life that we're living, we're gonna come across challenges. It rains on the just and the unjust. You cannot say, why did I have to suffer? Jesus suffered. What do you do with it? What's your attitude towards it? How do you view it? How do you walk through it? And can you have an attitude and know that I'm the temple? But not only that, I'm going to get to the temple so that I can be refreshed, so that I can be renewed, so that I can experience this sharpening. Jesus says, come to me, all you who are weary. Come to me, all you who are heavy laden. I will give you rest. And that means come to God from within. And that also means come to God and gather, and do not neglect the fellowship of the saints. So get to church, get up, praise God, go to church, get up, praise God, go to church. And this is the kingdom of heaven unfolding in you even more. And the unexpected can happen. The renewed right spirit happens. The goodness of God is expressed within you, and others feel it and see it. When you're running on a low battery, you go to work and people know it. You come off as if nobody wants to be around Debbie Downer. So put yourself in a space where you are continually praising God, where you're continually counting up your joys, where you're continually meeting and gathering to talk about the goodness of our God. Because the goodness of our God is compassion, who separates us from the chaos and removes us from the inevitable and takes us away from the deceiver and the ruler of the air. Because we might wonder, why does it always seem like the wicked prosper? It's not meant for us to focus on the wicked. The Bible says, don't worry about what happens with the wicked. God's gonna deal with that. But while you in your house serve the Lord, you in your house worship God, you in your house pray, let your house be your temple. Let your being be your temple. Let as you walk in the world, that be your temple, because God dwells in God's praises. So when you walk around with a praise every day, the scriptures also tell us to pray constantly. How do you do that? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. When you get up in the morning, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Abba. Thank you, God. Thank you for the breath in my body. Thank you. And it's the attitude and the posture in which I stand with. And every day I'm walking as the temple. Every day I am the church. Every day I am the hands and feet of Jesus, which means that we have to have an attitude of compassion and an attitude of gratitude. Once we lose our gratitude, we lose sight and we lose an understanding and a relationship that is like keeping us. And sometimes the circumstances can make us feel like, well, what do I got to be grateful for? Just think about this guy on the ground. He's laying there. And we know he's not there anymore, right? But just remember, he was there for his whole life. His whole life. And until somebody who had compassion, until somebody who understood his pain and could understand that he needs the kingdom of heaven to draw near. And when they did, miraculous things took place and he was made whole. I told you this sermon that John Wesley, I'm going to mention it one more time because I just want you to really take out the time to study and know the founder of your church, which is the Methodist Church, John Wesley. And at the end of this sermon that he gives called The Catholic Spirit, he says, not giving up meeting. Nope, wrong one. As some are, oh no, that's not it. Hold on. Where's my quote at? I apologize, guys. But I want you, I really, 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 really want you to hear this one more time in your hearing. He says, love me, but in a higher degree than thou doest the bulk of mankind. No, a little bit up. Not if thine heart be right as mine with your heart, then love me with a very tender affection as a friend that is closer than a brother, as a brother in Christ, a fellow citizen of the New Jerusalem, a fellow soldier engaged in the same warfare under the same captain of our salvation. When we recognize that our God is compassion and we realize that we are called to walk in compassion and that as we walk in compassion, the God of compassion gives us more to work with because we're trustworthy and we're willing to go and lift somebody up off the ground. We're willing to be responsible and see that there is a need and fulfill it. We're willing to say, come with me. Come with me to church. Come with me. I know a man from Galilee who can save your soul, who can give you eternal life, who can change your circumstances and turn it around. So as the church, as the temple of God, as the one who runs to the temple every Sunday, I invite you also to be one who beckons others in, beckons others to come to God and to see God, hear God through how you are, how your love is, how your compassion is. Our God's one of the first understandings of who our God is compassion. So we're called to have compassion. We can't say we love God and not love our neighbor. We can't say, so we have to be willing to say, I got something good and I want somebody else to have it. So don't only just get up and go to church. Don't only just get up and praise and go to church. Don't just get up and praise and go to church. Get up and praise and go to church and invite somebody to church. Invite somebody to come in and meet your beautiful pastor who can give a word, because the prophets, and I told you guys, I've been studying lately on my schoolwork and stuff, but the prophets were very close to the kings and they were called king makers or king breakers. And when you watch your pastor and you see that he brings favor to others, that he brings joy to others, that he brings hope to others, that he's a beacon of light, don't keep that to yourself. Get outside and bring others to the temple. Get outside and bring others to the love of God, to this compassion, because that is what God calls us to do. This is what God is requiring of you. This is what God, to love justice, God is calling for you. So I challenge you today to get up, to praise God, to go to church, and to invite somebody to church. I invite you to be revived and to hear this word as a sounding of the horn. Go out into the streets and tell others about Jesus. I'm inviting you, but not only that, if you believe that you're here for a reason, you believe that you came to the revival and you want to be revived, well, what I hear from the Holy Spirit is, come together. Do not neglect the fellowship of the saints. Praise God. If you feel downtrodden, if you don't feel downtrodden, if you feel good, praise God. If you feel sad, praise God. If you feel happy, praise God. Praise God in all things. Praise God in every circumstance. And most of all, be the temple of God. Gather in the temple of God and be the temple of God. The conference asked me to sing this song. They asked me to write the scripture into a song during I think it was a Lenten season, and I recorded it. I'm not even sure when it was, but I know that I recorded it, and I went and found the recording, and I want to share it with you, because at first, when you listen, it sounds a little sad, but I want you to hear the words as God calling us. I'm going to play it for you, and I'm going to sing with it, because though it sounds sad, I'm going to counterpart it. And I'm going to invite you to recognize the contrast. Tell your soul, get up, and you can turn anything into a positive thing. You can shift your view. On Wednesday, I said, don't look at things as if you're below. When you're looking from below, you're going like this. But when you're looking down, you're looking from the point of view that God sees you from above. And when you look down, you stop thinking about all the details and the things that are not so perfect. But instead, you see the bigger picture. And you can acknowledge that it's a miracle that you're here. It's a miracle that you're breathing. So many people are not. Don't waste another minute soaking, sorrowful, and say to God, I don't care if you don't bless me another, if you don't do anything else for me, I will praise you. I will worship you. I will glorify you. I will acknowledge you. I will share of your goodness. I will meet and fellowship around your love. And I will invite others to experience this love also. So I'm gonna invite you to just take a moment and listen. Pastor Quissico said he's been waiting for me to sing. So I'm like, really? On Zoom? But it's all right. I'm with you. Let us take a moment out and just meditate on this word. Come to me, all you who are weary. Oh, come to me, carrying every burden. I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Learn from me. I am gentle and humble in heart. Learn from me. You will find rest for your weary soul. Come to me. My yoke is easy. My burden is light. Come to me. Come to me. Come to me. Come to me. Amen. So I invite you once again to recognize that your God is a compassionate God. Jesus said, come to me, all you who are weary, come to me, all you who are heavy laden, I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. My yoke is easy. My burden is light. Learn from me. And that part right there, the learn from me part is learn compassion, learn understanding. Let not your heart be troubled, and don't be so quick to get upset about the things of this life. Learn from Christ by having compassion, having praise, having an understanding that we need each other, by coming together and being the temple, being the hands and feet of God, by not neglecting to gather and bringing somebody else up out of the pit, because you have the strength to. This beck and call for you is get up, praise God, go to church, invite somebody, and recognize that your God is compassionate and that your God calls for you to be compassionate too. Amen?
Amen, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise be to God. Thank you so very much. Oh my goodness, what a blessing we have gotten. God is good all the time, and all the time, God is good. And so all these powerful messages are yet another evidence of the goodness of the Lord upon our lives. So we are going to have a moment to respond to God's favor towards us by sharing our tithes and offerings. Those of you who are online givers, who know how to navigate the online giving, you will be free to do so online. And those of you who mail your gifts will do that. And those who are able to drop it off or bring it with you on Sunday service, we will appreciate as well. And so let me try this YouTube song on You Can't Beat God's Giving. Let me see if it can work. And then Sister Yolanda, on the other hand, she will be sharing a slide that show you how to give online and how to go about it. Amen. Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you. can't beat God's giving, no matter how you try, but do keep trying. Do keep trying. And before the benediction, I also want to share, this slide, which is an announcement as well, a reminder of where we are headed this Sunday. Amen. So I am going to share my screen so you can see this slideshow. It reminds us of our consecration Sunday, the things to remember. You'll see the various ministries that you can commit yourself to serve. This is our guest speaker, and these are the scriptures that are guiding us. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 9 to 10. Honor the Lord of your substance. God is the source of all gifts, talents, services, and resources. You have various ministries that you can contemplate and pick the ones that you feel called to offer, to share your ministries in. Nature ministries, if you feel called to any of the ministries listed under the nature ministries. Maybe you feel more compelled to serve in one of the ministries under outreach ministries. Maybe on the ministries under witness ministries, including evangelism, which is sponsoring these revivals. Or maybe it's auxiliary committee ministries, audit committee, communion, security, and so forth. And so you will have a form that you will be invited to fill up as well concerning your financial commitment for next year. That helps the church to plan and to budget and to know what to expect for next year. We are very much appreciative of all of your commitment as we are headed to next year. Amen. And so let us again put our hands together for our powerful, powerful, inspirational, provocative messenger of these three consecutive nights. She never gets tired. Her energy level is the same every single day. We are so grateful. We are so. When I grow up, I'm going to preach just like her. Amen, somebody. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And now let us give it up to all our friends from King's Highway and all other churches, our friends who are in the islands, our friends across the New York City and the United States who are on Facebook, on YouTube, including those who will be watching this service later on. We are also thankful to all of them. We are grateful for you, especially our friends from King's Highway who said, Pastor, wherever we go, we will follow you. We will be your backup. We will support you. And if anything happens, we will preach for you. Don't be afraid. Amen. Amen. That's right, Sister Dietrich. I see you. Oh, my God. King's Highway, a wonderful church, wonderful church. And so let us remember to come to church this Sunday on time as usual. Our services always start promptly at 11. And so we are welcoming Reverend Alpha Sylvester, one of our district superintendents in the conference for the Connecticut District. And he's also the Dean of the Cabinet. So we have a VIP coming from the Bishop's office to bless us. Amen, amen. And so let us be there on time and ready to receive as God provides through Reverend Sylvester's proclamation. We are blessed at St. Mark's. We always get the best ones. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. So if you ever wonder where is Reverend Wendy Paul, look for her at St. Mark's. She's there from time to time to bless us, and we are so grateful. Let us now commit to the Lord in prayer. Let us receive the blessings for tonight and the days that follow. Lord God Almighty, how wonderful, how awesome, how glorious and majestic you are. You always surprise us, Lord. When we think and feel like we have gotten it all, you prove us wrong all the time, for you always have something new to bring to our minds and to our hearts and to our souls. Every time one of your servants raises their voices to minister to us. We thank you tonight, not only for Reverend Wendy Paul, but also for members of our congregation, but also for the members of St. Mark's, and also for the members and friends across this globe who are able to participate, to share, to join in, and to listen up from whichever point in the globe they stand. We thank you, O God, for this gift of the virtual platform that allow and enable us to participate and to share of your word from anywhere we are. We thank you this night for those who are at workplace. We thank you for those who are in health facilities, be it a hospital, a nursing home, but they were able to tune in. May their souls be fortified and strengthened. We thank you for our sick and shut in who only wish they could in person come to church, but they are able to listen up. We bless them and we speak healing upon their bodies. Tonight, O Lord, as your servant has ministered to us, your holy word, we pray that let this word, allow this word, give us permission for this word to resonate with your people, with all of us, throughout the remainder of this weekend and through next week and all the days of our life, so we can remember, so we can be fortified, strengthened, renewed, and revived in the mighty name of Jesus, the God Almighty, who is the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We pray, we receive, and we claim in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh my goodness. I wish I could keep you all night long today. But you know, I'm going to be respectful of your time. The preacher loves you so much that she spared the time. And so I'm not going to spoil. I don't want to ruin the business. Amen. Okay. I'm only going to dismiss you with the song until we meet again. Let me see if I can find it. Until we meet again, and that is this Sunday. This Sunday, you need to find yourself. If you are not at King's Highway, I need to see you at St. Mark's. Amen? The only excuse is if you are at King's Highway United Methodist Church here in Brooklyn. Amen. Amen. God be with you.
God be with you till we meet again. Counsels guide uphold you. With these sheep securely fold you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet again. Till we meet. Till we meet at Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Good night.
Good night, Pastor.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Reverend Wendy Paul.
Amen.